morning. I'm Walter Stevens, and on behalf of everyone here at Channel 9 News, we wish you a very happy Halloween. It's 6 a.m. on October 31st, about 60 degrees in Geneva, 57 in Canandaigua. Most of the day should be partly cloudy with a chance of showers. Thank you for joining us this morning as pre-Halloween festivities are well underway. Starting on a scary topic, makeup and costumes are key for a candy-filled Halloween. Our fashion expert, Michelle Taylor, will review the top-selling costumes of 2010 and provide details on how anyone can make a unique homemade costume for this year's trick-or-treating. Rumor has it that many will be donning Harry Potter and wizard outfits this evening, so an appealing and creative ensemble will be sure to catch people's eyes. Later in the program, we get to bite our teeth into some spooky candy treats a local chef is brewing up for us. Reporter Dan Johnson is on site at the Geneva Boathouse, interviewing families about what their plans are for... Excuse me, folks. Seems we have some breaking news. Reports are flooding in about a toxic spill at a chemical plant close to Seneca Lake. Please be advised, the footage you're about to witness is startling, but rest assured, officials are working quickly to quarantine the surrounding area.
Can you go back to that station? I think there was an emergency warning.
I didn't hear. Sorry.
What if there's something important going on?
I didn't hear it. Okay, I want to hear some music.
I'm nervous that our lives are at stake.
What did you not understand?
Would you guys please knock it off? Come on.
Whatever.
I can't let her go like this. Elena, wait. Elena, I'm sorry I lost my temper. I know you're frustrated. I know you're going to have a great time here. Your mom and I went here and we...
Dad, she's not my mom.
Well, Tracy's been gone 3 years now. I know you're going to have a great time here. Just do it for me.
Okay, Dad. I'll do it for you.
If you're just tuning in, we're following the latest out of Geneva where a massive chemical spill raged out of control. Earlier this morning, Biotoxic materials were packaged and loaded for transport to an off-site disposal facility. Apparently, the driver of the truck lost control of steering and brakes while in the building and hit a steam pump, overturning the vehicle and causing an uncontrollable leak. The driver was fortunately unharmed from the crash, but immediately isolated and tested for exposure.
Hey, how can I help you?
Hi, I'm here for a tour. My dad set one up for me earlier.
Okay, and what's your name?
Elena.
Oh, Elena. Let me go get your tour guide. You can have a seat.
All right, thank you.
Dozens of individuals have been rushed to the hospital for side effects medical experts think are related to a bioagent named the Rift Valley Fever Virus, commonly classified as RVFV. There have been no reported fatalities at this point. We have reporter Dan Johnson standing by in Geneva with Dr. Marvin Hasgard, former biomedical consultant and researcher for the Center for Disease Control. Go ahead, Dan.
Thank you, Walter. I'm Dan Johnson, investigative reporter here on assignment at the Geneva Medical Center. I'm here with Dr. Marvin Hasgard, former biomedical consultant and researcher with the Center for Disease Control and Prevention. Doctor, do you feel the influx of patients here at the hospital today has any connection with the chemical spill at Seneca Lake?
Well, you know, Dan, I sincerely hope not. I've been looking at slides all day, and I sincerely hope that this isn't what I think it is. It's a form of the dengue fever that was mutated about 60 to 50 years ago. And we used it in a project in Vietnam when I was with the CDC in Atlanta. And if this is the case, then I don't know if I could talk more about it, but...
Doctor, this just sounds pretty severe and dangerous. What do you think the widespread consequences are for our community here at Geneva?
Well, you know, Dan, this is a project that I thought was dead 50 years ago. Back in the early 60s, I was a part of a project with the Center for Disease Control in Atlanta. What we were trying to do is mutate a virus that was going to be used in Vietnam. And I thought this thing was dead. This particular slides I've been looking at today are weaponized forms of this bacteria. What that means is that it's somehow been put into some kind of an aerosol or a fluid that can be dispersed easily in the air or in the water. And the fact is, if that's the case, you, your family, and everybody here needs to go. They need to get out of here immediately because this is evil. This is wrong. This should not have happened. This is supposed to be dead. This should never have happened. This was dead 60 years ago, but here it is back again, and I don't know why. And I'm very, very concerned about this, and I just don't know why it's here. But if it is, if this is what I think it is, there's a lot of people going to die. This is pure evil. And if you or your families or anyone else is here, they need to leave right now because it's going to be a lot of dead bodies.
You need to turn off the camera, Doc. You need to come with me.
What?
Turn off the
what?
Cameras.
In the 1960s, the United States military researched different components of RVFV to find ways to weaponize it, but funding for the biological weapons program ended in 1969. The virus found in initial tests this morning was in a much more evolved stage than anything.
Hi, this is Jack. He's going to be your tour guide today.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Did you see the news about the chemical spill?
I wouldn't worry about that. They've been playing it all day. Jack's going to take you on your tour. I'm sure that'll get your mind off of things.
All right. Thank you.
However, some reports are now coming in that the virus may be airborne and affecting the civilian population. Local authorities think this may be linked to a terrorist group. There's been no official word yet from Washington. The Center for Disease Control is suggesting residents living in the following counties should remain inside their locations with windows and doors locked shut for the time being.
All right, well, welcome to Huca College. If you look out the window, there's the chapel right there. A little bit over here is the library. We just got new Macs. Pretty exciting. Hanging through that window right there, that's where experiential learning is. And a lot of classes will be held there. Jepson and Strong are on the other side of it. Jepson's the science and math, and Strong is education. We can go visit the chapel if you'd like.
Yeah, sure. Sounds good.
Right, follow me.
Man, that doctor, man, he wasn't a mess. Was it a doctor? It was a mad scientist. raging mad.
Yeah, that guy was crazy. I can't get this tape that's shut off. It keeps recording.
Oh, what's wrong with it, man? It's not...
I don't know.
Come on, you're the camera guy, man. You gotta get it.
Whatever, we'll record you in the car. It's all right. Whatever.
Okay. Do you see that, man?
See what?
What is that? What's wrong with his arm?
Dude, I have no idea.
I don't know, but we gotta... I mean, the hospital's right there. I think we gotta just go check him out and see if we can get there.
Let's just leave him here. Let's just leave him here.
No, we gotta go. I think we have to go help him, man. The hospital's right there. We gotta go see what's wrong.
Alright.
Hey, buddy, excuse me. Is everything okay?
Man, look at the size of his cut.
Hey, buddy, is everything okay? Excuse me, sir. Is everything okay? What's I'm sorry. Are you okay? What happened?
I'm fine. Nothing wrong.
Are you sure you're okay? Your arm looks pretty beaten up.
I'll be fine, I think.
There's a hospital right there. We don't mind taking you in the car and all that if you want. Let me just take a look at it, see if you need some help. We can get you some medical help if you need it. I'm just trying to help, sir.
Alright.
We gotta get you to the hospital right now. I think, I've never seen anything like that.
Beautiful.
Yeah, it's a real amazing place.
So this chaplain, is he a nice guy?
Yeah, he's a real good guy. He helped me a lot of family issues in the past. I think you'll like him.
I'm sure I will. When are services held?
Non-denominational are Tuesday at 8.
Do you participate in services?
Once in a while.
Maybe I'll see you there.
Yeah.
I'm sure it'll be a good time.
Definitely.
Chaplain, you there?
This has been a frightening day for us all here in New York. Hospitals are overflowing with patients at this hour, but there's no shortage of volunteers from the Red Cross and other organizations. CDC officials have assured us this will be the very definition of containment.
Hey man, get off the stage. Dan? Dan, come on, we're live here.
Guys, I'm gonna get him off the stage. Dan, I know it's been a long day.
Just gotta get this part out of the camera.
Oh my God, you scared me.
Please don't use Laura's name in vain.
Okay, sorry.
I'm just messing with you.
Okay.
But really, don't do it.
What was that?
It sounded like it was coming from downstairs. I couldn't find the chaplain. He could be moving stuff near his office. If you go look at it, check it out.
Okay.
All right, follow me. Up on legend?
Sure.
The founder of this college, George Harvey Ball, had a wife who became ill, and on her deathbed, she made him promise never to meet anyone else, love anyone else, that sort of thing. Well, she was supposedly poisoned by the nurse, ended up passing away, and legend has it that the nurse and George became lovers, she was his mistress. And ever since then, Ball has been haunted. Creepy, yeah.
The building we were just in?
Yeah, the one where admissions is. But Chaplin seems not be here. So, can I look around and see what you see? Well, yeah, come look at this.
Ha ha ha!